I'm Paul, the running shoe guru, and this is Marathon Handbook. And today, something slightly different, I'm going to be talking about a shoe count that I did at this weekend's Manchester Marathon here in the UK. So I had originally planned and entered the Manchester Marathon. I had a few little injuries and niggles, so decided it wasn't going to be an A race for me, shall we say. So as I had a number and as I knew a few athletes that I coach and friends that were running in the event, I decided that I would park my car close to the 10 mile mark, set off in the race, do 10 miles at a tempo to gauge my fitness, see where I'm up to. And from then I would just give my friends a shout and give all the guys a cheer. But at the 10 mile mark, on the way back to the finish, it was a 23 mile point in the race. So I decided to do a little bit of a shoe count, and the figures, the numbers and the results might be of interest to some of you. So here they are. So I decided to count after the first 10. I figured a lot of the athletes, the race was one in two, just under 2:17. So I discounted the first 10 athletes past me, and then I counted what I thought was only about 100 people. I was recording into my phone. It turned out that I recorded up to 283rd position. So I recorded 273 results. And this is a breakdown of that shoe count. So the finishers were from approximately 11th to 273rd in the race, and the times, bearing in mind there could be a little bit of variation between 23 mile mark and the finish, the times were approximately 2:28 to 2:48, so only a 20 minute period as well. And you could say that all these guys are, you know, obviously clearly very good runners, you know, coming in well under 3 hours. So what we may refer to them as good club athletes. So here we are, let's dive straight in. First of all, I will do it by brand, break down the numbers, and then we'll look at the individual shoes themselves. So number one, I don't think it would come as any great surprise, even to perhaps Adidas, who now sponsor the race. In previous years, it has been sponsored by Hoka. This year, it's the Adidas Manchester Marathon. But number one, with 75% of the count, Nike. Carbon racers all the way there, really killing it. 75%, 74.7% of the count. Adi do come in second, but with only 8%, followed closely by, well, with exactly the same 8%, Saucony. Then we have a little bit of a gap to just 3.3% New Balance. Johnny Mellor, winner of the Manchester Marathon last year, was wearing New Balance. But this year, just 3.3% of those first 273 across the line, followed by Asics. Have we got an Asics? Oh, I forgot to get the Asics. But Asics were next with 2.6%, followed by Mizuno with 1.5%. Other bands made up just 1.8% of those remaining figures. So now let's look at the individual bands and the models themselves, because I did record the model data, and we'll check that out. Okay, Manchester Marathon. So here we are, we're going to look at the individual models that made up those 273 runners across the line. It did include the first seven ladies as well. Winner of the race was actually wearing Adidas, as they were in Boston, as it happens. So a podium victory for Adidas, the race sponsors in the Manchester Marathon this year. But the most popular shoe in those runners, again, this is up to a finish time of around 2:48. Predicted finish time, going off the results and what I counted people through. So number one represented shoe, Nike Vaporfly. 104 runners wearing Vaporflies. These were Vaporfly 2 and 3. I didn't differentiate between the two, but there were quite a good number of people who'd spent some of their Christmas money and saved it up and bought the brand new Vaporfly 3, the pink one. So that was quite evident. It would have been too tricky to break down the individual models, but Vaporfly, 104 pairs of those, closely followed by, and this one really surprised me a little bit as well, 97 pairs of Alphafly. And again, these were both generations. What I didn't see was any Nike Next Percent, the original Vaporfly. So they seem to have all, everybody's worn those out now and everybody's moved on to the original. So first, across the line, 104 pairs, Vaporflies, and then Alphaflies, both generations, and a lot of the new pink colours as well. So again, people anticipating the new releases and the colours and perhaps waiting to buy those for their spring marathons. The third most popular shoe, the Adidas, and again, the Adizero Adios Pro 3. There might have been some twos in there as well. There were a variety of colours, and Adidas have just released this shoe in lots of different colours as well, but 22 pairs in total. Third most popular, Endorphin Pro, with, I'm referring to my figures, 11 pairs, so a decent showing, but closely followed up in the packing, the new Endorphin Elite with 10. So together, Saucony having 21 to the Adidas 22 pairs. So closely, I think people maybe, it was easy to spot the new one. It's in one colour. It's easy to differentiate it with the midfoot band across there. So it's a very easy shoe to spot. But people may be moving on from the Pro to the Elite. So decent enough numbers for Saucony. Asics. Asics was a bit of a surprise for me, to be honest. I thought they might be better represented. 7 pairs. Metaspeed, Sky, Edge, and Sky Plus and Edge Plus. Very hard to tell the difference. A lot of the colours are very similar. So I put those all into one. So we're calling that Asics Metaspeed. So 7 pairs of Metaspeed. Next one, New Balance Fuel Cell Elite. Again, 1, 2, and 3 generations of these. Really quite difficult at speed when they're running past, other than the graphics, to tell the different models, but a total of 7 pairs. Mizuno, next, Wave Rebellion Pro. Just 3 pairs of these in that first 283 finishes, 3 pairs Rebellion Pro. And then that's when we start to spot a few training shoes. So we had Nike Vomero, 2 pairs of those, New Balance Fuel Cell Rebel, 2 pairs, then a pair of Saucony Endorphin Speeds, 1. We're into single figures now, guys, I'm afraid. 1 pair of Pegasus,
pair of Ender.
Come out of Kenya, they're made in Kenya. 1 pair of those. Puma Deviate Natural Elites, 1 pair of those. Hoka, surprised there weren't more of those. Just 1 pair, a pair of Carbon X's. So not Rocket X's, Carbon X's, just 1 of those. Then a Mizuno Wave Rider on 1. An Under Armour Velocity Elite, 1 pair of those. I'm not sure, I kind of half recognise the guy. I think he was an influencer. He had the full kit on, all the fancy Under Armour gear. He was wearing these, just 1 pair of Under Armours. And finally, 1 pair of On Cloud Boom Echo racing shoes. So there we go, 273 runners from position 11 to 274. Making up that shoe count. Some quite interesting, I mean, I think a lot of it is as expected. I was surprised there wasn't more Asics, wasn't more Adidas. The percentage by which Nike had it, with over 74% of the overall shoes, was amazing. And of course, this is the faster guys as well, wearing the carbon plated shoes. Of those shoes that we went through, 265 carbon plated or plated or nylon rods or whatever, you know, only 8 non-plated shoes went through. After I'd counted that, runners on the other side of the road were still going through the 10 mile mark. So we had the 3:30 plus runners, so 3.5 hours onwards. Still a lot of vaporflies visible and alpha flies. You can very vivid colours, the bright orange, the bright pink ones, a lot of those going through. But then certainly you see more of the other brands. So you see a lot more Books Adrenalines, Books Ghost, Asics 2000s, Saucony Ride, Guide, Triumph, that kind of thing. Mizuno Wave Riders, although they had one pair in the fast part of the race. So it is a very different, the sub three count to the plus three is very different, but really it's as expected. Nike with the Vaporfly and the Alphafly, they were first to market with it, weren't they? So they've kind of got a lead on it. Very interesting figures. I'll pop some pretty pie charts and things just to give you an idea there. But yeah, keep watching the channel. Comment below, what did you wear? Did you run Manchester? Did you run Boston? What shoes did you wear? Let's get some feedback from you guys. Subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and we'll see you soon with many more shoe reviews. I think one that I'm going to come back to, one of the next shoes I'm going to review, is the Endorphin Elite. I've been running some of my quicker stuff in this one, so I will do that one. And when as I did the first 10 miles at Manchester as well, I wore the Fuel Cell Elites, so they were very nice. Lots of great shoes out there, isn't there, really? So hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe. See you soon. Thank you.